All right. In the old days, I had a little magnifying lens. I'd say, you got it, you don't. And that wasn't fair, was it? Right? So I said, hold on. Now you get to see what I see. All right. So we're going to look at the sides of the hair and the back of the hair. This is the best hair that we have. And I'm going to compare everything here to the hair that you have through here. Okay. Sometimes it's generalized all over. And sometimes it's just in the five zones that mm-hmm. we talked about. But I'm going to look at everything. Okay. So let's look at the best hair that we got. It's right here. What I want you to notice are a couple of things. If we look at the individual, the hair fibers, right? So the follicle is under the skin, and then everything above here is the hair shafts that come out. But if you look at each individual hair fiber and compare them to the neighbor, they're about the same size, right? You don't see mm-hmm. super big and super small. These are all about the same size. Mm-hmm. Also notice this stuff in the background, that pinkish red stuff.
Yeah.
What is that? Blood supply, right? So then put on your thinking cap. When Rogaine came into the marketplace, right, they said what causes hair loss is bad blood supply, right? And that made logical sense. So they said if you get more blood supply to the area, it'll regrow hair. That's what they thought Rogaine, how it worked. Uh-huh. They found out later it was a prostaglandin, because if hair loss was caused by poor blood supply, would it happen when you're 18 or when you're 80, right?
Yeah.
When you're 80, So it wasn't blood supply. Mm-hmm. Now, what it really happened was it was a prostaglandin, so it's a growth factor. So it grew a little, but it never stopped the underlying biochemical imbalance that caused the hair loss, right? Mm-hmm. That's why it never really worked, and it never could work, right?
Okay.
All right, so now we're going to look at all the other hairs and see if they look just like this. If they are, you're out of here. You've got no problems, okay? Mm-hmm. We're going to go to zone one first. You tell me. Does that look the same? Doctor. Yeah. Two things, right? Doesn't look like those other hairs, and they individually are different sizes. Right. That can't be right, right? Something is going on, and there's a process in the blood. All I've got to do is rebalance the blood, and hair knows exactly what to do, right? Mm-hmm. So good thing is there's hairs inside the follicles. Now put on your other cap. If I look in here and I don't see anything, can I make it grow? Absolutely not, right? I'm not a magician, right? We're going to do what doctoring does, get you rebalanced, and then nature's going to take over. But the follicles have to be alive, right? You mm-hmm. came in, you come in too late, there's nothing I can do.
Yeah.
The good thing is, and now we're in an area, Tracy, can you give them a mirror? In an area that you almost don't see hair, and you're going to get a full hairline back yet. Right here. So you said, doctor, if you put it right here, of course I saw hair. Mm-hmm. But I want you to see that we're right here where it looks like there is no hair. Right. You see there's almost nothing, but when we go in there, look, there it is.
Yeah.
So I expect this to come. Is this going to come first or last? Last, right? This is the first affected, most affected, mm-hmm. the worst off, and then it starts to go back. As you thicken up, it's going to thicken in the crown and start to come down, right?
Okay.
That just makes logical sense, okay? All right, very good. So zone one, 100% affected, but 100% of hair is still there, okay? Same thing, right? Hairs are there, they just need to grow. And that's what happens. See how small these hair shafts are?
Yeah.
So the follicle underneath is also shrunk, right? So as that follicle gets bigger and gets thicker, the hairs on top will get bigger and thicker.